Hello students, today again we are going to learn the chapter 18 of your looking around book. The topic is too much water, too little water. In the previous classes I discussed about the three stories understood and about ORS. Hope all of you understood all the stories and you develop one idea about the importance of water, importance of healthy drinking water. Understood? Today let us discuss about the topic, why is it named so, that is too much water, too little water. Once it is told that too much water, again it is told that too little water. Let us discuss it today. Students, all of you know the whole earth surface, if you divide it into four equal parts, then 3/4 part of the earth surface is water. See, this part and this part is water. Then you can tell there is too much water in our earth surface. Understood? As only one part is land. That is 1/4 part is land. Understood? But student, here one question arises. Though there is 3/4 part of the earth surface is water, why we tell that too little water? Do you know why? As the 3/4 of water, among this 3/4 of water, the maximum water is present in sea and oceans, which is saline water, which is salty water, that cannot be used by living beings. Got it? Plants die if they get this sea or ocean water, or you can tell saline water. Understood? Second thing, students, other animals and human beings are unable to drink this saline water. We human beings also could not perform, could not do our daily activities with salty water. That's why it is told that too little water. Though in water cycle, you have idea about water cycle in lower classes. In water cycle, what happened? The sun's heat evaporates the water from the water bodies, means from ponds, lakes, rivers, streams. Okay, streams, ocean and seas, evaporate it and form cloud in the sky. By the process of condensation and precipitation, again this cloud, again this water come back to our earth surface as drops of rain. But most of the water again go back to the seas and ocean. Here students, there is little amount of water present on our earth surface for the use of all living beings, for plants, for animals and for human beings. That's why it is told that too much water, too little water. The water which we use, which all living beings need for their use, is that sweet water which is limited amount present in our earth surface, and that water is present in ponds, rivers, lakes, streams, understood, wells and underground water. Their amount is limited in our earth surface. Now come to this diagram. If the whole water, this 3/4 part of water, this whole water, if you think it as a bucket, bucket full water, okay, the whole water present in the earth surface, you, if you take it as a bucket full of water, then the water which all living beings can use is only 1 teaspoon, that is sweet water, only 1 teaspoon. And we are unable to use some part of this sweet water. Got it? Some part of this sweet water. As they are not clean, they are not healthy for human beings and animals. Understood? Now students, you have one idea that how much little water is present, how little water is present for all living beings for their daily activities. Hope now you can understand why the topic is named so, too much water, too little water. Then what is your duty? Tell me, what is your duty? Now it is our duty to save each and every drop of water. We have to save water. We have to save water. Each and every drop of water. We have to save each and every drop of water. Because water is very precious for all living beings. Water is our life. Its other name is, second name is life. No living beings can exist, can survive on this earth surface without water. Understood? So students, we have to save each and every drop of water. So many times I told you in this chapter that our earth is going to face challenges every day. So many challenges. In higher classes you will learn about them. Let me tell you the challenges. Pollution first, then global warming, okay, ozone layer depletion, so many. One among them is scarcity of water. Scarcity of water, understood? As its amount is limited in our earth surface. So we have to save water. Otherwise, it is not possible for all the living beings, not only human beings, for all plants, all animals, all human beings to survive on this earth surface. Got to. So students, hope you all could understand this thing from your book. And you all learn up to page 151 from your looking around book, this chapter looking around book. Understood? In my next class, I will give you question answers. Till then, still you all stay safe, stay healthy. Thank you.